Developers of today are faced with many challenges. How do you build for many different mobile platforms, integrate with different social networks, and use different services and APIs that are available these days? Windows Azure helps address some of those challenges, particularly with the release and general availability of Azure Mobile Services and Azure Websites, which make it easier for developers to target mobile platforms and also create really powerful backend services that can be used to simplify development process, save time, and also allow developers to focus on building code rather than working on the plumbing and the infrastructure for their apps. I'm Nick Gurkusha in the Windows Azure marketing team, and today I'd like to demo how some of the newest services, Azure Mobile Services and websites, could be used in a mobile marketing campaign. Here's a very common scenario, a mobile app. In this case, we picked an iOS, iPhone app, but could be Windows Phone or Android. And when we go into the app, we're presented with a login screen. And typically, this would require wiring up each individual authentication provider. In this case, we want to sign in with Facebook. And with Azure Mobile Services, we can just use the identity feature, and that does all the heavy lifting of interacting with Facebook for us. Once we put in our authentication information, Azure handles the rest and gives us back the successful authentication event. Here we go. Now, let's say we wanted to submit a photo for this contest. This requires uploading and storing binary data for the media, my photo in this case, and I'm going to just pick one. And the Azure Mobile Services can easily manage setting up the blob storage, providing us back with the HTTP post URL. And when we click submit, we can store the media as well as any other information, such as ID, date, time, etc. And we can also read that information back. In this case, the photos that were published, the data tables that are used by Azure Mobile Services makes it a very easy task. Now, we can also run an administrative backend leveraging these same services. Identity, for example, to authenticate with Facebook, reusing a lot of the same code, but now within a web app that's running Azure Websites. This communicates with all the same APIs that our mobile client app used as well. But here, in addition to retrieving data, we want to execute some functions on these photos. So for example, we wanted to approve or feature some photos, and we can do so very easily by using the new feature of mobile services called custom APIs, where we can expose as REST my data and other services. So we wanted to approve an image or feature an image, and then script actions such as push notifications, we can easily do so using Azure Mobile Services. And because there are so many moving parts to this demo, let's look at the project architecture. At the bottom, you'll see Azure Mobile Services and websites providing all the core services for our app, the plumbing, so to speak, and exposing it to our devices on the top left or the web portal in the top right. So in turn, everything in our solution can easily communicate with the identity platform, notification services, or third-party add-ons using Azure Mobile Services. My mobile client SDKs can use Azure Mobile Services REST endpoints to handle things like authentication, store and retrieve data, and Azure helps us manage interaction with blob storage as well. Mobile services also dramatically simplify functions like notification. We can script those very easily as part of our interaction via the custom APIs in our solution, and even have them executed on a schedule if we choose to. And again, we can incorporate third-party add-ons for sending dashboard updates within our web app using Pusher or emails via SendGrid. All of that is accessible via mobile services scripting, making it very, very easy to set up for our solution. And leverage the same exact services, third-party add-ons, custom APIs within our HTML web app as well. And we can do that using REST APIs. Now, in this video, we will be dealing with the client mobile development techniques, and specifically using multiple authentication providers, storing and reading data with tables, and also interacting with Azure storage for blob. And in part two, we will be looking specifically at some of the techniques around the web admin backend, leveraging Visual Studio to easily publish .NET ASP MVC apps into Azure websites, and also some of the techniques around building and using custom API for push notifications, and using ad hoc reports, as well as some third-party add-ons like SendGrid and Pusher to automate some of the common administrative tasks. So let's get into it. Using Azure Mobile Services for third-party authentication is quite easy. In fact, the work streams are divided into the work on the device and some configuration on the Azure. Let's take a look at the Azure portal. Here we access our mobile services, and from the mobile service we have options of different platforms, iOS, Android, etc., and options to create a new app or connect an existing app, as we can see here. To connect an existing app, all we have to do is include the right libraries for our Windows Azure Mobile Services and make the right references in order to connect our project to Azure Mobile Service. As easy as that. And now that we can connect to the app, all we have to do is configure the identity keys. And that we get typically from each authentication provider, Microsoft, Facebook, Twitter, etc. And once we put in the keys, Azure Mobile Services can then take over and do the authentication for us. In order for this to work, in the client itself, we need to configure the project and set up the typical storyboard in this case and wire up all the different screens, and as well as configure the screen that allows us to authenticate against multiple providers. And because we referenced our Azure Mobile Service in our project, all we have to do then is make the call to the Mobile Services client login function. In this case, Mobile Services does all the authentication for us, pops up the screen, validates the user, and then passes back the successful authentication event. So the Mobile Services can do the same thing for every single other device that's being supported right now, and our code, all it has to do is just reference that one specific function. So it doesn't matter if you're using Facebook or Google or Microsoft or Windows, that authentication can happen very seamlessly and very easily. On to managing regular data with Azure Mobile Services. Most applications these days require ability to quickly create data, store data, and also secure data for access. Azure Mobile Services does just that with Azure Tables. Let's take a quick look. Back in the Azure portal, we're going under the data feature, which provides access to all the different tables that our application has access to. In this case, photo submissions table is where we store the information for the different photos. That includes things like the title, the Facebook ID of the user that submitted it, as well as other information such as date, featured date, etc. Now, when we go to scripting, we can actually then script actions upon each of the operations, such as insert, or in this case, let's take a look at the read operation. In this case, we wanted to get only the top 20 rows or top 20 submissions and order them by submission date. This is the function that is executed in Azure, but could be very easily accessed from the client SDK. Let's take a look at how. So now we go into the module for submitting photos. And again, there we reference the Azure Mobile Services framework and specify and initiate the table, the Azure table that we want to access. In the next function, all we have to do is then specify the table name, in this case, photo submission. And to get the most recent submissions, all we have to do then is reference the read action that we just saw earlier, and we get back all the items that are in that table for our application. And it is this pattern of using SDK to essentially access Azure Mobile Services tables and then act on the tables using the scripting that really greatly simplifies the process of writing modern applications using mobile services. And finally, a variation of storing data in Azure is dealing with blob. In this case, the pattern is again very similar, some work being done in the device, and then configuration and scripting done in Azure Mobile Services. And Azure Mobile Services does all the heavy lifting of identifying where to store the blob and returning back the URL that the client then needs to work with to directly post the media using HTTP. And on the client, we run a data service class that wraps up calls to a particular set of tables. And all we want to do is get back the URL that Azure Services will provide us in order for us to be able to store that blob. We specify the table, photo submissions blob, and then we run the insert action on it in order to get back the blob URL. On the Azure side of things, we can see that if we go to the photo submissions blob table and specifically bring up the operation for insert, we will have scripting that provides that connectivity into Azure Blob Storage. And we have some account credentials that we configure, and through the Azure Mobile Services, all that plumbing, all that infrastructure work to go in and create and connect to blob storage is handled for us, and we get back the URL that we pass back to our client app. And with this URL, all we have to do then is take it back to the client and run an HTTP put method to take the binary and using the URL store that with all the credentials that Azure Mobile Services returned back to us. And that is it for part one of this video. In part two, we'll take a look at Azure Websites as a platform for our admin web portal, how we integrate it with mobile services custom API functionality, as well as scheduling features for scripting with third-party add-ons. For more info on Windows Azure, visit windowsazure.com. Thanks for watching.